Welcome to 2 Minutes with TYN, where we share our opinions, updates, and everything in between. This week, we'll touch on developments in the international community, such as the US sanctions, and look at the impact CNN's report has had on the ground. And finally, give you updates on the works of TYN. My name is Fasika, and I'll be your host for today. It has been over 208 days since the beginning of the conflict that onset the Tigray genocide. The US has finally placed travel sanctions on officials, and has cut security and economic assistance to Ethiopia. They call on other governments to do the same. CNN has reported on the abduction and torture of hundreds of men from IDP camps in Shire by Ethiopian and Eritrean troops, and this has led to their return, with the exception of a handful. As for updates from TYN, we have a new website we would love for you to take a look at TigrayYouthNetwork.org. There, you'll be kept in the loop on all our upcoming events, articles, donation links, and more. Currently, we're running a campaign to protest the buying of Ethio Telecom by Vodafone, Vodacom, and CDC. The money the genocidal regime will acquire through this will go directly into funding the death, torture, and starvation of millions. CDC is a governmental body, and this is not what UK taxpayers hope to fund. As for Vodafone and Vodacom, we hope the ethos will not allow complicity in genocide. Safaricom of Kenya have backed out, and we urge the others to follow their lead. Also, we have a protest on the 5th of June to urge the UK government to act, and we invite you all to show up for the people of Tigray with friends and family. The route will be the same as the last march, details of which will be found on our website as well as on all our social media pages. To our listeners, please join our campaign. This has been 2 Minutes or Less with TYN.